I now give the floor to the distinguished representative of International Service for Human Rights for a joint statement.
President, Mr. Forst and Yang, we welcome your reports. We join you, Mr. Forst, and some states in expressing our sadness and outrage following the murder yesterday morning of human rights defender Berta Cáceres in Honduras. We call on Honduras to guarantee the thorough, impartial investigation of this crime and commence inclusive consultations on the effective implementation of its recently adopted Defenders Law. Berta defended ESC and other rights of indigenous and campesino communities and denounced human rights abuses in the context of large-scale development projects. Her killing is emblematic of the grave risks faced by defenders addressing economic, social and cultural rights and underlines the need for a strong, substantive resolution on this theme by the Council. Your report mentions the important work of the African Commission to highlight violations against defenders on the basis of their gender and/or their work in areas such as sexuality, reproductive health and women's rights. We encourage you to continue cooperation with this and other regional mechanisms and to ensure coordinated implementation. Turning to your annual report, we welcome the clear articulation of 7 principles that should underpin policies and practices to protect and support defenders. Overall, they provide useful benchmarks for both your mandate and the Council to measure the extent to which states fulfill their obligations to protect defenders. Key among these is that in consultation with civil society, states should develop and implement specific national laws and mechanisms to protect defenders and investigate and ensure accountability for threats and attacks against them. We reiterate your recommendation to NHRIs to develop action plans for the protection of defenders and welcome the call for business to contribute to the protection of defenders by supporting them and condemning attacks on their work. We also echo your call on the UN itself to strengthen the protection of defenders, including through the Rights Upfront initiative and an enhanced institutional response to reprisals. In concluding, Mr. Forst, could you elaborate further on how states nationally and the Council in its resolutions could apply the 7 principles in contexts where defenders are at risk? Thank you.